Okay, the sun did come out for an hour or so. Not long ago. But, rowan trees, yeah. But the sun's gone in again, unfortunately. I have parked here. I don't think it's an official parking spot, but it's. I have used parked there before, and so far, no one's said anything. As I say, I was hoping there's a bit of sun shining, one or two patches. It makes all the difference when the sun's out, the colour comes out. Okay, it's surprisingly quiet this lane. It's a Sunday afternoon in August, and there is a campsite and a fairly popular lake up here. The sun is briefly trying to come out. Because I'm always it takes nearly half an hour for me anyway to get here at the end of this valley on by car because of the narrow lane, and I'm always a little bit hoping I don't catch too much in way of oncoming traffic. Okay, there's the mighty Avon Artro, somewhat reduced in volume, but still, it's not a trickle any longer. There has been a little bit of rain recently, and of course up here in the mountains, the rainfall tends to be heavier. There's the nice little waterfall there, the Avon Artro again. And it's quite a nice little picnic spot there as well, just by the waterfall. And there's a passing place there for cars, so you can't really park there. Okay, the sun's it's trying to come out. Might be in a bit of luck, but here is a footpath sign, but I personally wouldn't want to. I guess you could make your way up there, but it's there's no trodden footpath there as far as I can see. Still no cars on this road. Interesting perched boulders there. Now I'll tell a little story here. I read a couple of his books, mountaineering books, Shawl Stiles. He's passed away a few years ago. But he wrote, he was quite well-known mountaineer in his time. He wasn't a famous climber, but he wrote quite a few books, especially in North Wales. This was his favourite, one of his favourite places. He was taken here as a seven-year-old by his parents just after the First World War. And there's a little campsite at the end of this lake. And Mr. Shawl Stiles, age seven, climb that mountain at the age of seven. Yeah, so that's obviously right from a very early age. He was pretty keen on climbing mountains. Okay, I'll just repeat. The last half hour I haven't seen a car, which I find surprising. Because this is this is a beautiful spot, really. Cwm Bychan. But for some reason or other, there's no one here as far as I could see. Okay, there's the campsite at the end of the lake. There's a few cars there. have a point in the right direction again. The LCD screen, it's not very bright. I think there's a faulty brightness. I've tried adjusting it, but without luck. So I have to be kind of guess where the long distance shots. Yeah, I like it here. Wild Wales. There's the lakeside. You can see it's been blown over in the wind. Typical Welsh oak. And up there, the wilderness up there, the wilderness of the Rhinogs. There's cloud on the top of the mountains at the moment. There's the please pay here. Car is £3 to park. Camping £5 per person. But it looks like I can count about seven cars there. And I think they're parked to climb the Roman steps which goes up there. Funny enough, no one camping here. It is a weekend, but of course Sunday afternoon. Maybe people are packed up, ready to go back to the Midlands or wherever. Up there is Clip. I've got the ascent on that. Not all that long ago, took a video ascent. It's about a 1500 foot ascent from here. And here's the direction to the Roman steps here. That's what people come up here to park, to walk up the Roman steps. Site. I'll just go a little way up this path, or at this point it's a track, just a little way up here towards the, I won't go as far as the Roman steps. Okay, I'm doing a little bit of ascent here. There's a good view of there, a Clip. It's just under 2,000 feet above sea level. As I say, I do have it on video, taken maybe over a year ago, but about, let's say, 1500 foot climb. Okay, I'm just, as a stile I've just crossed it, crosses a fence, this fenced off woodland here, and then the path ascends through the woodland. Very little wind today. Wild country this. The Rhinogs. This is where the boundary fence is reached. Right here. There's the woodland there. Here's the somewhat rocky path going up towards the pass. There's another walker there, a lone walker by the look of it. Again, I can't. There he is there. I just continue off here just a little further. There's a little kind of stone bridge just around the corner here, I think. Okay, here's this little stone bridge here. Yeah, quite interesting. It's not, I don't think it's meant to be, well, it may have been originally a little stone bridge there in ancient times, but gentleman by the bridge, he was waiting for his wife, and there's one or two other stragglers back there as well. But the Roman steps are further up, so I'll just go up a few more yards, because that way I won't be caught up, because it's a nice day. I just go up a few more yards, but of course I think the Roman steps as such, which are kind of flat slabs laid down in medieval times, quite a bit further up. I'm planning on doing this walk. I kind of wasn't thinking quite. This is in Cwm Bychan. I was thinking of going up to do a lane walk on a lane walk on Cwm Nanco, but I absentmindedly drove up the wrong. By the time I realised my mistake, I thought I'd carry on going. There's the other stragglers. They're just disappearing. They seem to be going at a reasonable pace. The one guy's well in his 80s. So now this is as far as I'll go, as I did ask the one of the stragglers there how far the actual Roman steps, the flat slabs, which are quite impressive. But he said they're quite a bit further up. And unfortunately, I wasn't planning on this walk, so I didn't bring those boots aren't waterproof. I was going to do, as I say, a lane walk up the adjoining valley. All right, so I'll just retrace my steps now. But that's nice. Yeah, you got the the official autumn is less than 2 weeks away. It was 22nd of August, so you get the nice the purple heather. When the sun just come out, so that's nice. Show up the colour. All right, so this is I use this tree as the end point of this walk. I'll catch up with the old timers. Okay, I'm back to the edge of the woodland. I left the old timers. They were having a break by that. Well, I think it's been repaired, but it was probably an ancient bridge. Dating from, Roman times. There was obviously a track over the pass there in Roman times, but the Roman steps themselves were a medieval project. Okay, there's an ancient farmhouse. You can tell by the small windows. Probably dates back, to the 16th century, and maybe even further. Isolated farmhouses, the last habitation in this, I think it's a beautiful valley, really. Okay, so I've done most of the descent now. Now I'm trying this camera out on the HD high definition setting, which I've stopped using recently, because it takes up so much memory space, and also forever to upload to YouTube. So, but I'll try it out on this camera. See how the high definition works. Okay, the cloud has lifted a bit, and yeah, you got a view of Rhinog and it. You can climb Rhinog Vawr from this side up the Roman steps, but there's another rough route as well. There's a lake halfway up. You can ascend that way, but most people, I think, ascend Rhinog Vawr from the other side, the Trails Vinith side. Yeah, that's the end of this walk. Unfortunately, it did. The sun just briefly came out for a few seconds at a time. And of course, down there, it's probably been quite sunny on the coast, which is about maybe 5 miles away. And when I left the house, of course, it was sunny, but as you go into the mountains, it generally does cloud over. Okay, my car's just around the corner here, so that's the end of this walk.